concerns are still the same. I don't, you know, I accept that changes are coming, changes have to come, and I don't have an issue with that. My concern is genuinely down to the time, the implementation of the new constitution from, you know, from October to having implemented in May. The representatives from the LGA raised an eyebrow at the idea that it was going to be done in 6 months. I think he advised 18 months to 2 years is typical of that. And even the advice from our Director of Governance and Insurance is that in an ideal world, he'd be given 18 months and he'd be able to draw up something specific to Wirral. The 6 month time scale means, to put in this phrase, an off the shelf. That is an off the shelf constitution that he can implement in time for May. My genuine concern is having it rushed. We should be doing this once and getting it right. I accept that it should be a live thing that is ever evolving. But if we're going to do this, I do genuinely believe, I know they're doing this the way we move, a delay until 2021 of the implementation of it will give council staff and elected members time to also be made aware through workshops, training, whatever, of what the changes will be, how it operates, and things like that. I just don't believe that the 6 months is allowing enough time for that. That is genuinely sort of my only concern, is that I think it's going just far too fast to implement something so big a change in less than 6 months.
A sense of resolution then. Phil, beneficial.
I think one of the few members in the council that was here when we changed last time, when the youth structure came into being. And in those days, we moved to a strong leader on work for a period of time. We had a committee that looked at the procedures of the cabinet, and there was a committee that ratified cabinet decisions. So we went through a year or so of changing over on memories. The question is, in those days, we were asked to try it and see it, and see it work in practice. So we've had 17 or 18 years of trying it and seeing it, and in practice we found it wanting. I think the reality is that the writing has been on the wall for the present system for some time. Members have been thinking about a change because of the dissatisfaction for some time. What members wanted was a meaningful involvement in decision making that also meant something to their constituents. That's what I'm striving for. I think Paul is saying, Councillor Stuart is saying, well, there's a risk of more haste, less speed. Listen, I take the view that we need to get on with things. Members have complained over the years that things have been streamlined and things have been streamlined. But I'm sure that we set up a working group, which is what's proposed, to get round the table, plan it in detail, and get it sorted out. Timetable should be achievable. I did send an email to members during the day with some suggested resolutions to add to what's before us. But my belief is that we need to get on with this. The electorate expects us to do something to serve them better. It has been highlighted over time to the electorate by various parties, and the reception I've had is that people want to know what cabinet actually does, and they want to know what the council does. As things stand, the council can only comment on things the cabinet does, or ask them to consider something, or ask them to look at it again. Sometimes in budget time roll over the cabinet's decision, but then the cabinet come back with an alternative budget which has to go through. So the council's powers at the moment are not what the public expect us.
Okay, Chris.
Thanks, Chair. I'm with Gillian Minister. I do believe we need to get on more straight away on this cost. We've got something that's coming down and we need to roll with that. I just want to go back to the costs, because it was one of the issues that was raised at the old member working party. But if you look at the costs, you know, a lot of the costs, well, let's start first with the constitution. We've heard from the director of government insurance very often about the need to rewrite Wales constitution. But basically, it's not worth the paper's written on. And you know, that cost was going to be incurred come what may. Am I right in saying that? The director, that cost of rewriting the constitution will form part of this. And if we don't go down this route, it still will be incurred. So there's no increase in cost there, as far as I can see. We also have to remember that we've got 10 cabinet members or scrutiny committees who get allowances. That will come to about £110,000 a year. I'm pretty certain we won't have 14 committees all incorporating costs. So a fair chunk of that money will be saved year on year. So this 70 to 250,000, if it was 250,000 in 3 years, we'd be paid back on my calculations. And there is only 70,000 we're cash up front in the first year, you know, but we're saving money. So having gone through the paperwork, having been to the working group, the government working group, and heard what was said, I'm clearly, as you're gathering the opinion, that we have, as I said at the outset, we have the wherewithal to do this. We have that assurance from the Director of Government Insurance that we have the wherewithal to produce this new constitution in time for next year's council. We have
concerned at the pace at which it's been suggested. If members were happy to take legal expert advice on the issues that Moira can be produced or the constitution can be written, I think we should also have to accept the advice on what it's going to cost us. Can't pick and choose what we accept from this report. And I think we have to open this. This has got to come in at the highest, which is 200,000 or even 70. As lead on finance, we have to finance. So I'm just saying that we should think about the pace at which we're doing this, and then I think there will be a cost incurred, and I don't think we can dismiss that advice from the legal whilst taking on board other advice. So we accept his opinion on it.
As well, to get that chance, I think what head of governance and insurance also said, it's a little bit thinner than the year before, and I think I understand why that would be. I think the actual structure of it is not. So that will have direct consequences for the actual costs. So it is a little bit intangible, whereby you're only ever going to get a ballpark figure at this moment in time, I would suggest. But again, it's been suggested that, you know, if the extra cost actually means that we make better decisions, which means that the bad decisions that cost us money that shouldn't have happened in the first place never come to pass, then it's almost an invest to save, isn't it?
Yeah, what I was saying is that almost in there we will. As a committee, it's a result of pushing this faster than I think is actually wise. I'm not saying you can do this. You need to sit back and think about doing this properly, as Paul said, and actually minimising that cost, because it's also taxpayers' money.
Justify the cost, whatever that ends up being, but it shouldn't be applied.
spin that on its head as well and say that senior officers, we've had one or two since I've been around, have a tendency to move around as well, and that you could actually say, isn't it better to use these skills and abilities that are available to us whilst they're still here? I'm not saying you're going anywhere, Phil.
Not that you know yet.
Statements many times with the goals that he would be
no saving there whatsoever. I see a saving to the people of Wirral if we move this forward in 2020.
Thanks, Chris. If we're all done on questions and comments, I'm guessing there's at least one formal resolution that wants to get put to the floor. Shall we?
In light of what we've said, what Janette said, and some of the important piece that we've got amendment forward, which I've typed up and just circulated by you through the launch of that council.
The committee
held at its meetings and subsequent member sessions, this committee considers that Wirral's residents will now be better served by the introduction of a more accountable and transparent way of conducting the council's business, policy formulation and decision making. It is the opinion of this committee that the council should now move to a committee-based structure to be designed, finalised and in place for the next municipal year. The committee notes that a range of costs in the board apply to the revised arrangements. It is recognised, however, that revisions to the existing constitution have been under discussion for some time and that costs would have been incurred in that process. The committee is of the view that the operational cost of the new system of governance should be the subject of regular reports and that in practice these should be minimised. That prefixes what's in the committee papers on the number of page 159, Chair. I would move that with the addition of the committee recommendation as set out in page 159 with the dates of annual council 2020 as set out there, 16th of March 2020 as set out in paragraph B, and as set out in paragraph C, the operational constitution for 2021 municipal year in draft form for consideration in February 2020. So, that's entirely clear to members, and that's what I propose. And I'm happy to take any second.
Will that become an amendment?
Yes, Chair. Yes, no, just to confirm that's close enough to the proposal for the amendment. So that would be a vote on
the amendment.
I'm
first.
Sorry, Chair, just to be clear. So, Councillor Gilchrist's amendment is an amendment to our proposal.
suspend the moderation panel from that point once we knew what we were actually